Hi guys, welcome to Cognitive Hub Talent Tutorials. In today's video, I am going to explain about T-File Input T-Limited and T-Logro components in Talent Studio. And also I am going to explain about how to load a contents from D-Limited file and print it in our console. Now without wasting any time, let's dive into the topic. Okay guys, this is the Talent Open Studio, which is a free version that I have installed previously. And every minimum task in Talent Studio will require a new job here. So that is what I am going to do now. So I am just creating a simple job here. So to create a job, you need to go to the repository panel on the left side in your screen, and right click on the job designs and click on the create job here. So just these are all the options that you will get when you click on the create job here. Here both purpose and description are optional, but the best practice is to fill all the three fields here. And the constraints in name is you cannot write the name with the space, with including the spaces. You can append the words by using an underscore, or directly append the words by just combining the entire word. Like I am just using the file name as load underscore input file. So underscore is okay, sorry, the file is already existed here, so I am just removing the underscore here. So load input file, purpose is usage of T file, input T limited. So and description, I am writing it as loading the contents from delimited file and printing in our console. So these are all the, so there is no warning showing in the top area. So once you are done with all those fillings, then you can click on the finish here. So it is appearing directly in the script designer tab here. So by default in the backend, the job, the whatever the content you have written, like you have written in this designer tab, will be written in the Java code. So if you want to see that particular Java code, you can go to the code tab here. And also this is the by default, the first of all initial code that you will be having in the designer tab for a empty project, like for a empty job. So if you create any components here, according to that the code will modify, and if you get any compilation error also, you can view it in the code tab here. Okay, so here our main task is to load the data from the file which is present in our local system and print it in our console. So for that, what we need is the component. In Talent Studio, everything is based on the components itself. If you want to store the data in the database, you will be having some component. And if you want to take the data from the database or file, then you will be having a separate component for it. So for loading a data from a delimited file and print it in our console, we will be having a component like a T file input delimited. So you need to insert a component here. So there are mainly two methods of inserting a component in the designer tab. One is you can directly search it in the palette, like T file input delimited. So once you are, this is the file, this is the component name that we need. So once you are done with the file name, you can click it on the search button here. So you can directly drag it and drop here the file name. So this is the component which will load the data from a file, delimited file in our local system, and load the data. So it is showing a warning like no schema has been defined yet, and this component should have output links. So those two things that we need to configure here. So in the component, what we need to do is, first of all, we need to insert a component, and the second thing is we need to configure that component, and the finally we need to assign that the output to another component or to the output component. So here we have clicked a component here, and you will be having a component tab just below the designer tab. So you need to go here. So for now, just keep built in both property type as well as in schema. I will tell you about what is repository and how to use that repository later by using a metadata. So for now, we need to mention here the path, here file path. So where you need to get the data. So we need to configure the, we already have a sample text here, desktop. I am just going to YouTube folder here. So here talent, we have a sample.txt file. I am just opening it. So directly we have a sample.txt file copied here. So before that, I am going to tell you what are the contents present in that sample.txt. So these are the contents. The first line is the header path, and the next four lines are the contents that I have written. So let's see whether that content is able to print it or not. So here the row separator is by default, it is a new line, and the field separator is we have comma there in the output in the notepad, and it is not a CSV, so I am writing here. The first line is header part, so I am writing it as header one. Here in the sample.txt, the first line is first name, last name, and age, so which is a header. So I am just making the header value as one here. So what it will do is, it will just ignore the first row. Suppose if you mention here two, then it will ignore the first two lines from the that particular file which is present in this particular location. So for now, we need to ignore only one row here. So I just written header value as one, and footer we need to print everything, and limit is also now there. So this is what the initial configuration for this input file delimited we need to do. So once we have done here, so if you want to check whether the data is loaded or not, okay, the data viewer option is not there. Okay, so now you need to print the loaded data into the you need to print the data into the console. So for that, what you need to do is, we have another component like tlogrow. So this is the another method of inserting a component in the designer tab. So this is the component which we use to insert the data, print the data in the console. So what we need to do is, the output which is present here, we need to connect the two components using the main here. So here we have two connectors here. One is main as well as reject. Sorry, one is we have row trigger, that is which contains a main. We already used the main here. This is the main row. Main is nothing but a which carries a data from one component to another component, and we also have another one like a trigger. Trigger is nothing but if you link the two components by using a trigger, then it will be checking for if on sub job. Okay, means suppose if you have two sub jobs, suppose on component. Okay, that means if the component executed without any errors, then it will get executed if you connect the two components by using a on component error trigger. So I will explain all those things in the later lectures. For now, here the main, we have connected the two components using a main row here, main connector, which carries the data from this component to this component. So here another thing we need to do, we connected the output link, but we need to assign a schema for it. So here we have a edit schema here. Here we need to insert manually. So click the plus button in the below part in the pop-up screen. So you can modify the name here, the first name, and it is a string, leave it. And again I am placing here, and next one is last name, and it is also a string, no problem. And next one is age, but it is a number here. So click the drop down menu here and click integer here. So and save it. So I am saying okay. So just click the propagate changes, yes here. So see here, there is will be no error messages once you configure the schema here. So here what you need to do is, here the schema was successfully connected to output. The data will get loaded from this file which is present here and print it in this particular component. So the output component, so just go to the run tab here below the designer tab and click the run button here. So first of all save it, clicking the control S and click the run button here. So everything, if everything goes fine, then it will print the all the rows that we have in that particular file. So what it is saying is starting a job and then connected to a server. So these are the contents that we have in this particular file, Rakesh Veluri 35, and these are, so this is here in the tlog row component. So the job was executed successfully, but what we have is it is not in the form of a table format. Suppose if you want to print the output in the form of a table, you can change, you can click the tlog row component twice and you will be directed to the component tab below the designer tab and change the mode into table from the basic mode. So again save it by clicking control S and go to the run tab again. Just clear the out console and again click the run button. So now we will be having the output in the form of a table. See, this is the first name, last name and age is the contents that we have given in the data, like a schema definition, and these are all the things that we have in the form of in the file. And this was displayed in the form of a table. Previously it was displayed in randomly without any padding and all. So this is how we are loading a contents from a file which is present in our local system to unprint it in our console. And in the coming lectures we will discuss about how to store this particular file which is present in our local system and storing it on in database, and also we will discuss about how to retrieve the data from databases and display it in our console. So that's all for this video guys, thank you.